the Samurai, former NPWA Champion of all last year. Recently, he's been on a hiatus here from the NPWA for the past 3 months after he lost his NPWA Championship to the man known as Hollywood. Today, the Samurai returns to the squared circle. He will not have the World Championship belt around his waist. He will be starting over on his road to get back on track to becoming NPWA Champion for a second time. We'll see how the Samurai does today, moments away, in his matchup against Justice today on NPWA Wrestling.
Bill Bronson here. Taking a look last week now. This is highlights where the masked man was on the roof. The masked man that's been following Justice around was pointing him out on the roof. The special Connecticut Championship match between Rock Richards and Justice. Then he was not on the roof as the match went on. And then at the end, look at where he came from. So, with that in mind, we're going to take a look now at the Samurai as he's going to take on Justice. Are you ready for this, Tom?
Technical difficulties aside, we'll be able to commentate on this match square and fair, give the people what they want to hear.
There's Justice. Justice in the ring now. We're waiting for the Samurai. We've been waiting a long time to see him in action.
Well, I know he's better watch his back.
Justice better.
The Samurai.
Thunderous ovation for the Samurai. What's this with the yellow belt?
I think that stands for sweat. If I believe correctly, the man has sweated.
Well, you've been involved in Shotokan. What does that mean? Is Shotokan Karate the yellow belt? That's the beginner belt, is it not?
I always thought the yellow belt was one of the beginner belts.
I think that the Samurai is starting over.
Starting over.
Look at the master man's put on in the 3 months he's been out. Wow!
Whoa.
I guess he hasn't been training too much.
He's been training with the bad boy.
He's going to give him a run for the money. Good old Maggie at home's taking great care of the bad boy's body. With the food, that is. Wow.
Food, that is.
Either that or, I don't know. Samurai is deep. Well, yeah, he put on about 40 pounds.
At least.
Since the last 3 months we saw him. At least is right. All right, Justice, the match has started. And the masked man is having
a...
I'm looking on the roof. I do not see him there.
Bronson, how can you see anything with those thick glasses of yours?
I can see that arm drag. Samurai's pulling on the arm with his leg.
You know, though, those glasses could be like binoculars for you. You could probably see like a mile away.
I don't have to look a mile. I'm almost ringside.
You could probably see 500 miles away. See whenever Mad Mike is coming.
Isn't he the ring announcer? I can't see that.
Then you're in luck.
It's great to see the Samurai. Scott Oresko's favorite wrestler, the Samurai.
Well, I know he's your favorite wrestler. You chauffeured him around enough over the years.
I drove his car one time, and that was the last time he lost the world title.
Well, you're a gold digger. You're a regular gold digger, Bronson. You go where the gold is.
Samurai trying to get out of this.
You don't want to reply to that remark? You resemble that remark. Reply.
Whoa. I don't need to reply to that. Why would I stoop to your level of replying to a remark like that?
Isn't it true that you don't really want the Samurai as the world champion?
Why is that?
Well, you know, you're not with him now all of a sudden. I mean, you know, you don't hang out with him and all of a sudden he doesn't have the gold. What's going on?
I don't hang out with the champion Hollywood.
I see what that guy all the time. You're saying good things about
never.
Him.
Never.
All over the place. All
it's
the time.
Disgusting. Despicable display to our sport here.
He was running down to the ring, handing him the belt.
I did never. No.
Driving him all over the place, chauffeuring him.
I do not do that. No. I hate to tell you, but I don't like Hollywood. He put his hands on Scott Oresko. He put the Samurai out. I cannot wait for the day the Samurai regets his championship match. I can't wait.
Wow. Well, I guess we know whose side you're on.
Justice. The Samurai going at it. If it's up here. Two fan favorites.
Well, what do you think so far? The Samurai hasn't lost a step, or he lost two?
I think he's got a little ring rust on him. It appears to me that he's slowed down a little bit with the added mass weight.
Just like
now
that.
He's going up to the top. Running up to the top rope.
The agility is
Oh! Wow, he caught the ref pretty hard there.
It's not quite what it used to be.
Now Justice going up to the top. Oh, no! What? He's grabbing a chair. A chair? Justice, a chair? He just nailed the Samurai with a chair.
Well.
Then now he's going for the... What the holy fuck?
Under the ringside table.
He was underneath the ringside table. Is he all by me?
Bronson, how long could he have been there? I mean, we've been here all day, and we haven't seen anybody.
That might have sat there.
We were here.
That might have seen nothing anyway.
We were here when they set up the
and
arena.
And your winner of the match,
Oh
Samurai.
Wow. Hey, I know this bad guy like the back of my head, and he wasn't here all day.
Well, this is the house of action where anything happens. It certainly did. Unbelievable. Whoa.
Uh-oh. Now we got Sonny D out there.
What is this guy doing out here? He's got no business out here, Bronson.
The manager of the World Heavyweight Champion. We got a few officials to help Justice out of the ring. I cannot believe that Justice, what is the fifth week in a row now, has been attacked by the masked man. When's it gonna end? And we gotta find out who he is.
Well, they're carrying Justice out of here.
Again. And Sonny D's making a challenge to the Samurai. Oh, look at that! The manager of Hollywood. His arm looks fine. He doesn't have a sling on.
Get this guy out of here.
Wow.
What's he picking fights with the Samurai for?
Well, he doesn't like the Samurai returning to the NPWA. World Heavyweight Champion's manager.
Whoa! Harsh words.
Samurai wearing his yellow belt. That is... Man's lost a lot of pride in himself.
Next week, right here on
the man Mike with that silly hat.
Samurai, you and me, nose to nose. Anything goes. Come on, buddy.
All right. Well... Hey, you see the replay.
Where's the replay? I'll take care of this.
Oh, look.
This is where this... this masked man, La Belly, comes running out from under the table of all places, and he just clocked.
How did Mad Mike not know he was under there?
I have no idea. Maybe he was in on it. Maybe that hat. Maybe that hat did something to his brain, squeezed his head, cut off the hearing in his ears.
Wow.
The referee had just enough then to make that count. And the Samurai was hightailing with the victory here, you see, until Sonny D showed up.
Well, we're going to find out a lot more about this. Sonny D has made a challenge of the Samurai for next week. You heard it. It's probably going to happen.
Sonny D makes me sick.
Oh! This is a review now of Sonny D's. He's a manager of Hollywood. This is when Hollywood won the title at Superstar Showdown. Let's take a look at the highlights. I think that was it.
I think Hollywood thought that was
it.
It is it.
Oh, my goodness.
History has been made in the NPWA arena.
I can't believe it.
Believe it, Bronson.
Do you really got him?
That's your champion.
Organizers got the belt.
New
you heard it.
Champion,
I can't
Hollywood.
Believe it.
Oh my goodness.
But what are you, sit, you're standing up, Bronson. Sit down. You're not going to do anything.
I can't believe it.
And many wrestlers have tried to do this, but Hollywood has succeeded where others have failed. Well, I'm shocked, folks. Bronson has just hightailed it out of here. I don't know if he's got the guts to step on it, but I'm telling you, there he is. He almost tripped his way in the ring, tripped over that silly ponytail. I don't know if he'll ever wrestle again.
Like garbage. But what it was a demonstration. It sends a clear message that you want to be a wrestler and you want to be champion in the world today. Watch, look, open your eyes. Everybody in here, everybody on national TV, and every other wrestler, there are no more.
Well,
this is professional.
Well, right now, they are seriously attending to the Samurai. Hollywood, the new champion.
Well, that was Superstar Showdown, and next week it's now official. We just got word. It's going to be Sonny D taking on the Samurai.
Whoa. Well, Sonny D is going to get his butt white.
Let's go to ringside now for our tag team title matchup.
Yes, I'm Bronson. You know what I noticed?
Ladies and gentlemen.
In that last piece of footage. Let me tell you something, Bronson.
Match.
Did you drop your knees quicker than Monica Lewinsky for the Samurai?
We got another valet, I think, being introduced here.
They're the team from New York, Brooklyn, New York.
Another one.
The New Warriors, Rage, and Fury.
The New Warriors. The New Warriors being led by Lady Elizabeth, I believe.
And their opponents from West Palm Beach, Florida, weighing in at 210 pounds, Hot Rod Brown, and his partner from Canada.
The champions are about to enter.
The Lightning Warrior, together,
two-time champions,
tag team title holders, Hot Lightning.
Wow, there they are, Bronson. The two-time, you said it, two-time NPWA. The greatest tag teams that ever stepped in there. Of course, besides myself and the Headbanger.
Well, skeptics will disagree and people will agree. Who knows? That match never took, well, it did take place once. And who ended up being the champions on that match? Sonny D and the Bad Boy. So, weird things
happening. That was another ploy by the suits in the NPWA. House of Pain, House of Action.
Uh-oh. The customary March is always beautiful.
Stand at attention. Everyone, come on your feet, please. Thank you. It's time!
You're working the crowd very well, huh?
He knows how to do it. He knows how to play the fans, play the crowd, work the action. And here he goes, a treat for everybody at home once again.
Are you ready?
One of the greatest physiques ever. Look out, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Look out, Lupo. Oh! Hot Billy Bob. Look out, Lady Elizabeth.
Hot Billy Brown is hit there. Wow. Was that really worth the wait?
Take it off, Bill.
Now the tag titles are on the line here. Rage and Fury, this is their first ever tag team title matchup. We'll see how well they do. Rage, he's definitely ready for this. You saw him last week. He was involved in that mixed tag match. Now he has his partner. Lightning Warrior got Rage. Whipped him in the corner right at the hot body's knee was there, and Rage felt it.
Well, this is going to be quite the tag team lesson for Rage and Fury. That's my opinion.
We can see new champions. That's my opinion. Oh, tag body block. Next week, by the way, Tony Black takes on Rage in one-on-one competition. We saw what happened last week when they had that mixed pick a partner match. Things didn't go too well. Samurai gets Sunny D as well. You'll be here for commentary during that. Stay out of the ring.
Are you talking to me?
Yes. You're in no shape to attack Sunny D when he returns. You didn't attack him this week, but he's here.
Bouncing. Right now,
oh,
all I have to worry about is commentating. Wow.
The chances of that man climbing up that ladder are slim. Let me tell you, I don't mean that in the worst sense of him.
He's on the right of our screen and he's going on a ladder. I don't think the camera picked it up yet, has it? Bad boy walked out with a ladder and he set it on the right side of the ring.
Well, now he's got a chain.
He's got some kind of beverage.
Looks like he's got a grinder in his back pocket. Or maybe that's just his Depends bunching up. I don't know. I don't know what that could be.
We're going to go find out.
Well, you go find out. Send Mad Mike to go find out the deepest, darkest story there.
Incidentally, Scott Oresco is here today. And after this matchup, Scott Oresco is going to conduct a one-on-one interview with the Samurai. I can't wait to hear what he has to say.
Well, big surprise, you know, Scott's big interview every week seems to be with the Samurai.
Well, that's not changing what usually happens.
I mean, come on, this guy's no stud, all right? Thinks he's the Desert Storm Fox or something.
Right hand by Hot Body takes Rage down. The new Warriors. Led off this week by Elizabeth.
Who?
Elizabeth, they called her.
Not bad.
Oh! Whoa! There's a ladder outside. Bad Boy brought that ladder out. Sherry don't want him to use it. Bad Boy, tell him, don't get near my ladder.
What's going on? This ought to be an automatic disqualification, and they retain the belt. Hot Lightning, that is.
The Bad Boy don't want nobody using his ladder. I think he's using that for lunch later.
So he can step up to the buffet. Where's he go? The Green Giant buffet. He's down with OCB. We all know that.
He's got the old country buffet.
That's right.
He goes there. All you can eat for what? $8?
Something like that.
Hire the help now.
The Bad Boy would know. You know, they got a time limit there, all because of the Bad Boy. Thanks, Bad Boy. Overstaying your welcome as usual. The guy who doesn't know when to quit. He doesn't know when to quit eating. He doesn't know when to quit a gimmick. Come on, Bad Boy. Jeez. that gets me mad.
At least he's got clothes on today that are staying on.
So far. You know, one bite of a sandwich and that could change everything. The bridges will drop right in a heartbeat, let me tell you. The belly wellies will be willing, all right?
Raging Fury got Hot Body Brown, whip him in.
Double lariat.
Could have new champions, I'm telling you. But I don't know why the bad boy's out there. I guess he just doesn't like anybody in there. He's a former tag team champion, don't forget.
Whoa!
Shoulders are down, huh? Just got it out.
No way. That was a nonchalant pin. You're not going to get Hot Body Brown with a pin like that. With a big elbow like that, a big powerful elbow. You're not going to stop Hot Body Brown. Guy's been around. That's a former world champion on like 8 different occasions.
Two times.
Well, at least 8.
Oh, he just winded up the clothesline rage. Bad Boy's got the championship belts around him. How did he get them? That's an insult.
Easy.
Definite.
Oh! Double axe handle, grabs the leg, and tags the Lightning Warrior.
You know what I see when I look at Hot Lightning? I see confidence. You can feel it. You can smell it when they walk in the room. It's a smell of confidence. Unlike when the bad boy walks in the room, it's like the smell of grinders, you know? Oil and vinegar running rampant.
Drop kick.
Double knee.
Well, the bad boy is still at ringside. He's got the championship belt still. I don't think you can really eat too many of those.
The fans loving those chops.
Well, everywhere you go around the country, fans chant woo whenever a chop goes on. No, any idea why?
I think that's because of me. I think that's something I inadvertently started. Double drop kick, holy cow. Double meat, double drop kick, it's all here.
Come on,
Rich. And a kick out by Rage. Bad boy taunting Hot Lightning with those championship belts.
Well, Bronson, I was going to say that Rage had guts, but the bad boy's got them all.
Oh, my Rage. The bad boy, you see him sitting there. He's got the belts, and he's just taunting Hot Lightning with them. You take a look at it. Well, look at him.
He's big enough to be a distraction to both teams.
Look at this. He's just paying attention to the
fans. he's thinking about something. Probably a big old OCB buff.
Oh! You're free there, boy.
He can't wait to get up to that free chocolate milk bar. He just can't wait.
Oh, we got a referee out.
No, we got all screen.
Now we got all four men in the ring, and referee got inadvertently knocked.
Well, this almost resembles last week when he lost control, but both teams know who their partners are this week.
What's the bad boy doing? He's going to eat the referee.
Well, it looks like he is about to take a bite out of the referee. He's peeling back like a $2 Snickers bar, one of those big ones.
He took his shirt off and... Oh, don't tell me he's going to take over as a referee for this thing. He'll never fit into that shirt.
You can hear the back of that. Buttons are popping off of that shirt.
You stretch it. Wow, he fit right in there. Nicely, I might add. Oh! Hey, he just dropped down with the belt on top of Hot Body Brown. And look, the bad boy's in there.
What?
Whoa, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Whoa! Lady Warrior hit the referee.
Just in time. Just in the nick of time. Well, he's not even the referee, Brown.
Yeah, he can't call it a foul. He's not even the referee.
He's a wrestler.
Now what they're doing.
Professional eater, but he's no referee.
Bad company's out there.
He's
just slam on the Lightning Warrior. Uh-oh. He's going for seconds on Fury. Third? Haven't heard of it that much. There it is.
Well, we can see here that Bad Boy don't have nothing better else to do. What's the matter, Bad Boy?
Choke slam.
He's picking
up
the show up this week.
He calls it the Heimlich
referee. Yeah, you don't want a piece
he
of this boy.
He got everybody out, but the referee is out cold.
Hey, you in for a little fun?
Oh, that company's out there. I don't know what they're all about.
What was Tony Braxton, the Swedish Chef, doing in there? He's going in for roll. I thought he was going for six big old main courses.
Well, we got officials out there outside the ring calling it. And the guy, the ring announcer, called the match.
Tony Black is hot after that. After that choke slam. After that Heimlich slam.
Well, I guess this is a double disqualification because what can you do?
What are you talking about? Clearly, Hot Lightning wins this one fair and square. That's the way I see it. I'm sure that's the way the commissioner, Todd Peters, sees it.
Now the Bad Company beating up on Rage and Fury. Tony Black takes on Rage next week.
Nobody Brown and Lightning Girl, you paper champion. If you have any guts,
what? Is he
you'll hook themselves up against the real tag
guts.
Team.
Nothing
like these wannabes.
Tag team situation in the NPWA is incredible right now.
Wow. You have the guts.
Hungry for that title belt.
Put that title
on
the line.
Well, tag company's in there. And they're throwing Rage and Fury out of the ring. Wow. Here you see the replay, how the referee got it.
Wow, right there, and then from there, you saw the Bad Boy eat his way to another t-shirt. He ate his way through that shirt. He made this ridiculous attempt at a count, and then he dished out, count him, five
Look
or six
another
choke slams. And he was hungry for more.
Well, it broke down at the end. But that'll do it. No contest, I guess, because referee was out. Hot Lightning took off.
Wow.
But we're getting ready now, Tom the G, to wrap it up. But before we go, we're going to send it over to Scott Oresco.
Oh,
standing by with
not
the man.
That interview. Come
yes,
on.
He's going to take on.
My pleasure right now to bring
Sunny
up next week. NPWA champion, the Samurai. Samurai, I know you're not too happy these days. You know, losing your title to Hollywood. What do you want? Do you want that rematch?
Well, that's all I want, is the rematch.
That's all you want.
I didn't ask much from this federation, but the only thing that I really need to get right now, for my own spiritual enlightenment, for my own sake, is to get this rematch, and I have to get the belt back. I think things were going great. I was climbing to the top of my game. I did everything I set out to do here in the NPWA. Then I ran into a problem. I think once I got the belt, I got a little cocky. I lost sight of my fans, I lost sight of myself, and I lost sight of my art, which is Shotokan Karate. And as a result of that, I think it was only justice that I lost the belt. The belt goes not only to who's in the best superior physical shape, but also the best in spiritual shape, and I wasn't. But I'm back, you know, I've trained hard, I've gone back to Japan for a little while, I'm back now, and I'm at the top of my game once again. All I ask is that the NPWA give me another shot at the belt.
Samurai, of course, you know, if you need me in your corner, I'll be there.
Well, you know, this is the type of thing a man has to do on his own. And I appreciate
Understandable.
It. Understandable. But it's not about wrestling at this point for me. It's about the person I am. It's about my character. He's going to face a much different, much, much different samurai this time around. The samurai I used to be. And the samurai that's going to win me championships from here and out into the future, and I'll never lose sight of that again.
All right, well, Samurai, hopefully that match, you know, if Hollywood doesn't duck you, because I don't know what kind of champion he is so far.
Well, he hasn't ducked anybody yet. And I don't think he's going to duck. True, we haven't had a rematch this late in the game.
That's what I mean.
But
trust what's
I don't believe he would have really ducked. He can stand up to his own challenge. He took me on the first time. He'll take me on again. And I'm really, really anticipating that. Looking forward to that. Can't wait to get back in the ring, get my belt, which should be around my waist,
That's right.
back again.
All right, Samurai. Well, so hopefully this match will happen very, very soon. Samurai looking for the rematch with Hollywood.